and let's see if I can cover this extremely quickly. ML-KEM and at least MLDSA are NIST Federal Information Processing Standards. All relevant IP on the use, implementation, deployment, use in a business interest has been licensed by NIST so that anyone who takes this document, this standard, and uses it for any of those things is not liable, does not require a license, does not require any intellectual property approval. Yes, here it is. And I think people just don't know about this and they don't look at it. NIST has entered into two patent license agreements to facilitate the adoption of the announced selection of PQCP encapsulation mechanism crystals, Kyber, and similar for crystals dilithium, which is the basis for MLDSA FIPS 204. NIST and the licensing parties share a desire and public interest the licensed patents be freely available to be practiced by any implementer of the ML-KEM algorithm as published by NIST. ML-KEM is the name given the algorithm in the standard derived from crystals Kyber. For a summary and excerpt from the license, see over here. We're going to go look at that imminently. Implementation of the algorithm specified in the standard may be covered by U.S. and foreign patents of which NIST is not aware. NIST has entered into two patent license agreements to facilitate the adoption of NIST announced selection of publicly encryption PQC algorithm crystals Kyber. Same languages. Licenses cover a patent portfolio privately owned by a U.S. entity and a portfolio controlled by French institutions. Yep. Also related to M2 Prime. Is that the same document? Almost exactly the same document. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. 2016, blah, blah, blah. What? Fine. Algo consulting. Similar. Pairing with errors. So this is Jintai Ding. Mm-hmm. Status ceased. Okay. The licenses were drafted such that any implementer of the Crystals Kyber algorithm as published by NIST received the benefits of a grant to the licensed patents within the scope of a field of use limited to implementing Crystals Kyber as a PQC algorithm. The licensors agreed on a royalty-free basis to place into abeyance any right of enforcement of the licensed patents against any implementer or end user of the algorithm. So it's not just if you wrote code that implements FIPS 203 or ML-KEM, it's a user of the algorithm of an implementation as well. I mean, that makes sense. Like, that's not useful if you, the only people who are free to do the thing is the people who wrote the code. That's relevant language modifications to the licenses regarding the scope of permitted use of implemented language of both licenses. Okay. Implementer. And the entity, person, company, organization, foundation, or basis where the private, public, or governmental implements algorithm for any purpose that complies with license granted in paragraph 2.1. Whether such implementation is for research, teaching, and other non-commercial purposes, or for the purpose of commercial, manufacture, distribution, or provision of services or products for a fee. Products, any apparatus or composition encompassed within the scope of claim and license patent and implementing the PQC algorithm and shall be also include a product that is manufactured at least in part in a process encompassed by a pro scope of the license patent, blah, 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 blah. Okay, license processes. The process that implements the PQC algorithm, of course, being practiced will be encompassed in the course of claim. License patents, blah, 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 blah. License uses. Any method encompassing the license scope of, within the scope of claim and license patent, and implementing the PQC algorithm that has not been held not patentable, invalid, or enforceable, blah, 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 blah. License territory worldwide abandons all of the, like, patents stuff. Field of use. PQC algorithm, any standard prescribed by NIST in a special publication and federal standard based on the Crystals Kyber public key encryption and key establishment algorithm. That was in the registrar. Yes. Effective 2016. Cool. Or subsequent such NIST announcement. Documentary standards set by DIST Standards Development Organization or Standard Setting Organization and government regulation or statute where in instance of BNC, blah, blah, blah. licensors, grants to licensee, an exclusive, non-transferable, fully paid up, irrevocable license, the right to grant sublicenses, Algo Consulting Agreement. Yep, we know Algo Consulting. Terms limiting sublicense to the field of use. Okay, fine. Using it to do post-quantum cryptography. Oh. Licensors agree this agreement extends and confers all benefits of the grant, paragraph 2-1, to all implementers and their end users on a royalty-free basis for the field of use. Doing post-quantum cryptography. Place into abeyance any rights of enforcement of the license patents against any implementer and their end users from any and all actions, cause of action, claims, demands, whatsoever in law and equity for all claims, patent infringement, direct or contributory inducement otherwise, which may arise at any time after the effective date, which can be preserved against any implementer and any of the implementers and users, or direct or indirect, or immediate or remote, arising in any implementation of the PQC algorithm, concentrated scope, field of use. Licensors reserve the right to use technology covered by any claim of license patents, grant rights to the license patents for uses outside of the field of use, and enforce the license patents for uses outside of the field of use. Still just, yeah. For the U.S. portfolio, for the sake of clarity, any implementation or use of the license patent by licensor, sublicensee, or any other party that does not meet the definition of the PQC algorithm, including any modification, extension, or derivation of the parameters, is not an implementation or use of the PQC algorithm. Oh boy! Oh boy! How interesting. Wait. Oh god. This is where fucking commas really matter. Okay, all right, implied from the rest of the sentence. Does not meet the definition. Okay, I thought this was all cut and dry, but this also kind of makes sense. If you tweak or extend ML-KEM as defined in FIPS 203, you aren't necessarily fully protected against the fucking patent thing in the United States. I'm not a lawyer, nor let alone a patent lawyer, but that's what it sounds like to me. Interesting. Right. Field of use is any implementation. Okay, and now let's see if I can find the answer to my question on some specific about this from ages ago. Okay. I asked NIST. This was about, like, this thing keeps saying, based on the crystals, Kyber, public key encryption, blah, 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 blah. And like the actual document is ML-KEM. And the reason I asked is because ML-KEM hashes in the hash of the public key and it hashes in a hash of the ciphertext into shared secret key derivation. Sorry, Kyber V3 did that up through V3. ML-KEM does not hash in the ciphertext into the shared secret key derivation. So you could argue that they're different. They're different schemes. They're definitely different functions. They don't, you know, they behave differently with different inputs. They have different outputs for different inputs. And I was specifically like, is this like a loophole for these, you know, licensing agreements? Yes. PQC algorithm shall mean any standard prescribed by NIST that is based on Crystals Kyber. ML-KEM is covered. And not Crystals Kyber, since as you pointed out, they're not 100% the same. We're very clear with their lawyers that this is what we wanted. We wanted the algorithm and our standard cover since we knew there'd be small changes. But yeah, if you are using ML-KEM as written in here, and it seems to be, I'm not a patent lawyer, but it seems like even if you used part of it, this modification is doing a lot of work. I feel like you could use the public key encryption part of ML-KEM and probably be fine. I am not a lawyer. Certainly not anyone's lawyer. But you might be able to make this argument as fine. But if you change it significantly, extend it significantly, or derive from the parameters, that in the United States, you are not completely relieved of worry of this US portfolio thing. But anyone who's just using ML-KEM as it's written in 203, you're fucking fine. So that's fine in my non-lawyer opinion. But yeah, if anyone's still complaining about IPR shit or worries about patents on ML-KEM, and like they have a similar thing for, let's see if I can find it, for MLDSA. Yeah, so there's not even a thing. Cool. But yeah, that's it. Okay, I'm calling it. Straight up ML-KEM is not patent encumbered. It just really isn't. Bye.